Hi, I'm Alyssa Berman Cutler. I'm at the University of Chicago, where I work in the Office of Civic Engagement on our UChicago Local Initiative, our efforts to realign our purchasing and our hiring with the needs of our communities, as well as the Polsky Exchange, which is our business incubator on 53rd Street, which supports small business entrepreneurs in the community. Just by sort of shifting the way that we think about this work from just a business diversity lens to a place-based lens, I think it's given us the opportunity to work with a lot of different kinds of businesses. So now we look at what's in our community. We can support a lot of these smaller, traditionally business-to-consumer businesses, but we buy a lot of that too. And so all of a sudden, we're really supporting the little mom and pops as an anchor institution. The other thing that's been really powerful has been the work at the Business Incubator. At the Exchange. So we have about 3,000 members right now. About 600 of them are from the community and have no previous affiliation with the university. They are there to work. They are there to learn about entrepreneurship. And they're really excited. And this is a totally different, I think, narrative. A lot of them are in tech businesses, but a lot of them are in product design businesses and are coming up with the next new science idea or arts and crafts idea. So I think that from our perspective, being able to tell those stories as part of the entrepreneurship story, the 1871 story that I think we hear much more often, is really powerful. So I spoke about sort of the entrepreneurship program. Then there's also the leveraging of our purchasing power and the training that goes along with it. So Jackie was one of our success stories. And I would be remiss in not talking about CASE, the Chicago Anchors for a Strong Economy, who is our consortium of anchor institutions in Chicago who are all really dedicated to this idea of how do we look within our own home communities, support and nurture the businesses that haven't had an opportunity to get in the door in the past and meet them at their needs. So for someone like Jackie, who's a very successful business owner, it's really more about just kind of finding those opportunities for those who are a little bit smaller and need specific kinds of training, bookkeeping, and that sort of thing, either providing that or finding the resources to do so. And so that's been really successful, kind of tying that training to the opportunities that we have. I do think little mini neighborhood cases of Chicago Anchors for a Strong Economy could be tremendously helpful. So most communities have some larger institutions. Are they banks? Are they social service agencies? Are they hospitals, little community hospitals? I don't know that they think of themselves as anchors in the same way that some of the larger ones in the Chicago area do. I think sort of the community economic development agencies and chambers in those neighborhoods, reframing for them their role in that ecosystem and helping them think about themselves as the community anchors around this kind of purchasing could be really tremendous. Helpful. The other thing is the supports that already exist, and I think that right, this is very informative. We don't all know about all of them, and there are entities around the city that help organize this, and it's a huge task. I know there's a lot of people thinking about this even more, how to communicate this in a larger way. That is still needed. A lot of us sort of on the ground know how to make these referrals, but it's not done in a systematic way. And I think that, developing those kinds of larger policies around that would be helpful. At the same time, I think everyone's sort of better understanding and being honest about what their niche is going to be really helpful in this business supportive landscape. I come from running a community agency. We were very good at knowing what was going on in our community. That's where we could be the most helpful. We weren't as good at, really how do you develop your books in a way that the banker is going to accept it. Knowing how to hand that off and who to do that to and who's in the ecosystem and being okay with that and not saying that you can do everything, I think is helpful.